Hello friends, today's video is a little bit different. I will be reading my prayer journal to you. Prayers about gratitude, the world, my battles, all spiritual things in Christ. I hope you will be blessed. And as I read to you, I'm just going to use this fan brush as your relaxation trigger. Lord Almighty, I lift my eyes up to you and worship the great God that you are. Perfect are your ways, holy, upright, and wonderful. You tell us to walk humbly and to seek you, obey you, and trust in you. And that is what I do, Father, on this very morning. I seek you in order that you would increase in my heart and in my life, and I would decrease. Please, Father, give me wisdom, humility, and love, that I would treasure, love, and serve you first, and others second. In my natural, sinful state, I love me first, you second, and people last. And this is not the way you've commanded your children to live. Help me, Lord, to adopt a better character, rooted in godly wisdom. And done in a godly servitude. I pray for those around me. Bless those around me beyond measure. That their hearts lead those around me in your ways, that the ways of the world would not entice. Give them hearts that hunger and thirst for you. Thank you, glorious God, triune and powerful, all-knowing. Thank you for breaking barriers. Thank you. Thank you for allowing us to use our gifts, to use our passions for you. Where the world sees science and the universe as their God, we recognize you as Creator, worthy one, holy, and good. I pray for this broken world, that they would be set free and saved by the name above every other name. Oh Jesus, good God, gentle Spirit, Holy Father, move through this wicked world, this world that has defied you generation. In your power, in your will, using us as godly instruments, in whatever way you see fit. Bless the people, our church, Lord. Bless them in all ways. We thank you, Lord, for how you have designed us. Please be a light to us, O God. A true joy, that the light of Christ would find the darkened hearts and fill the great void that is so great. Be glorified, O great God, as we seek your will every day. Everything Over the years, I have read Ecclesiastes and marveled at these chapters, and how, ages later, they still remain true. The world has physical seasons as well as spiritual. There is a time for everything in this world, and we must accept that it is all vanity. The only things in life that are not in vain are God's purposes, and the life to come that is everlasting. These are for the Lord, and in the Lord's plan. Nothing in heaven is vain. Solomon says that in places of authority and places of righteousness, even there lies wickedness. How true and unsurprising. The world is evil, and so are the inhabitants. We mustn't forget. Like a child distracted with something pleasing to the eye, mankind is persuaded by appearance and charm, all the while their heart is prone to destruction. I pray that the Lord God would keep us from wolves and sheep, and protect us from ever becoming those people ourselves. Both we can be blind to. I pray we always walk in integrity and in humility, in Jesus' name. My God, Father Almighty, please work on me this day. Give me vision. Give me insight to see all that you do. I am blinded by my own selfishness many days, and fail to practice loving you, loving others more than myself. Please put flames of resentment that ignite from time to time when thinking of certain people or experiences, and let flames of love and understanding take place instead. Let my heart be shaped and transformed by you, Holy Spirit. You who hovered over the void and created all that is seen, hover over my heart, fill it with life and light. Please be pleased with my heart, I pray. Amen. Father, thank you for your glorious hand in my life. You give me wisdom in my human stupidity, hope in my hopelessness, and answers in my confusion. The temporal vanities are swallowing me whole, and I have been consumed by them. Forgive me and cleanse me, O Holy God of all. Give me the same fire to do your work in serving church members and serving the lost. I am wicked by nature, and like an infant, I open my needy arms to you asking for help. I pray you would give me Solomon's wisdom, I would understand the vanities under the sun. revive this broken world, I pray in Jesus' name. Father, Almighty God of the universe, thank you for life. Thank you for this blessed existence filled with light and three-dimensional joy. Yes, some days are harder than others. There can be far worse things in life that could happen. I try not to think of those things, but try to be grateful to my Creator for all that I have. Bless my fellow man and my neighbor, O God of Israel. Bless those in great need and show me how to serve. Love those you set in my path. Let those who do not know you know the love of Jesus and be changed and transformed by you. I pray you would work in their hearts and set them free from all chains. Help me, Lord, be self-disciplined. It is a challenge for me more than ever, but not impossible. I humble myself before you and know I am weak, and how much I need you in all things. I praise you. Choose humbly. online with you. Help me to see others, to see their value above my own. How hard it is to love others as yourself when you love yourself too much. Giving the self abundance of gifts, praise, time, and focus. How hard it is to love others this way when the cup for self is full. God, forgive me and plant my feet firmly. Help me to focus on the needs of others and have great empathy and compassion. As you see fit, Lord, as you see fit. I found the prayer I wrote on Sunday, April 25th, 2021. This is the prayer I wrote right before I started this channel. Lord, I am getting ready to start a Christian YouTube channel and humbly come before you asking for wisdom, guidance, and comfort. As things happen, lead me away from temptation and lead me to discipline and obedience. Deliver me from evil. I can only imagine what darts the evil one will send my way. Please keep us all under your wings and teach us as we go. You are an awesome God, mighty and powerful. Remind me how our days are numbered and how quickly our days pass. You remind me how incredibly blessed we are to even have life, air in our lungs, bodies infused with souls. How very lucky we are. And I pray we wouldn't take it for granted. Open your sons and daughters' eyes so they see, ears so they can hear, lips so they can praise and confess, hearts so they can pray, and lives so they can truly live. Be praised, O God. None is more deserving than you. In Jesus' name, Lord God Almighty, thanks be to you for your sovereignty. My soul is so troubled by this very sick and troubled world, and I wonder how you can stand it. How can you be so incredibly patient and so merciful to such blatant wickedness? I am thankful you are both forgiving and righteous. I know I am in need of your patience and forgiveness every day. This world is tough, but we work hard, Lord, and ask that you would help us to be more loving and others focused. Help us to let go of every idle, overwhelming want and selfishness. Help us to serve our churches, our people. Pray for self-discipline with food and luxury. Please help us to be better, to run to you for all satisfaction. Father, be pleased with my whole life. You know what is in man, and therefore you know what is in me. Sanctify this soul daily and pour forth godly wisdom and insight unlike I have ever received before. My days are filled, and Lord, life is full and can feel like one giant to-do list. Help us to keep our eyes on you. Lord, I take comfort in knowing you. Knowing you know all thoughts that float around my head. can rest knowing your spirit is in control of everything. Worries can float away. Anger settles. But love can pure and amplify a selflessness. I rest in your hands completely, Lord. I pray, Lord, for an unreal love, that I would love others as you love, in Jesus' name. Father, lover of my soul, you are who you say you are. Thank you for awakening my being and reviving your personhood to my mind. I am moved when I understand more of who you are. I pray the words that touched my heart would be shared with the world around me, and your purposes would be in motion. Many times I read of the raw and wild relationships the prophets would experience, the wonder, the awe, the supernatural lives. Oh, I am hungry for it. Is there a way to live this way and still be a responsible person in society? Perhaps it is selfish, I don't know. But I pray and I'm willing to learn from you, Father. Open my heart and eyes in Jesus' name. Amen. Father Yahweh, search me. My life is in your hands. Tell me how to serve you in this season, and I will. Who can I feed? Who can I bless? Lord, I want to pay it forward as you have done for me. Lord, I desire to change my affection towards money, luxury, status. I desire to live like I have nothing. Perhaps living like it's not our world would be best. I pray, Lord, you would protect me online with whatever evil comes my way. Please shield me from it. Protect me and those on this platform. I am unable to fight wolves, but I know you see and can destroy evil at its door. If any of this is ever wrong, Father, take it away. I will serve you till my last day. Father, Almighty God, what is happening in this strange world? Why does the corruption continue rampantly? Is there an end to the madness of this twisted generation that is hungry, ravenous, relentless in turning God's word upside down? What is good and upright is bad and oppressive. What's bad and oppressive is this age's version of good and upright. How long can it go for? The Lord heals the broken, but injures the pride of the upright. Religious hypocrites. Their egos bruised, personas revealed as a sham, whitewashed tombs rotten on the insides. Snakes, poison, proud scam artists, greedy and self-indulgent, callous to the needy, sought to receive wealth, fame, and power, corrupt to the very core, ravenous wolves, sheepskin, hungry to prey on the weak, confused and living in self-deceit. We must be careful. We do not see ourselves outside of being this way. If they have deceived themselves, so we can deceive ourselves. We must bring our hearts before you, Lord, and choose to do things for you in secret. The world will puff up its chest and say, in pride, when being good, charitable, or loving. But the humble will be exalted, and the proud will be humbled. Father, you have brought me out of darkness and confusion when I was neck deep in it many years ago. Lord, you have given me sound theology, beautiful church family, and introduced me to a life that is fulfilled. This is the first time, Lord, where I see amazing things happening in my work. I ask you, Lord, that I do not worship or idolize any of it. I pray that you would not be disappointed in my heart. I owe my entire life to you, O King. You've done much for me, Lord. I thank you and pray I would do what pleases you. In Jesus' name. Lord Almighty, you are Creator. You reign on high. Just, yet merciful. Powerful, yet restraining. Patient, yet swift to act. Are not contradictions of character, but reminders of your many attributes. Lord, is it strange hearing mere humans repeat your characteristics that you've said of yourself? Or does it connect us better to you? Creation acknowledges its creator. What an honor it is to be human, made in your likeness. And for your purposes, to warm my heart with reminders of who you are. We are worms apart from you, yet you are high above all the filth of humanity. You adopt and care for us as your own. All life avenues are useless and destructive if they do not lead you. All is vanity. And Lord, I thank you for giving us hope, for giving us soundness and wholeness. There is hope in you. Oh God, flood our hearts. Change this broken, disjointed system on perpetual self-destruct. Fill our Today's video is a little bit different. I will be reading my prayer journal to you. Prayers about gratitude, the world, my battles, all spiritual things in Christ. I hope you will be blessed. And as I read to you, I'm just going to use this pen brush as your relaxation trigger. I lift my eyes up to you and worship the great God that you are. Perfect are your ways, holy, upright, and wonderful. You tell us to walk humbly and to seek you, obey you, and trust in you. And that is what I do, Father, on this very morning. Seek you in order that you would increase in my heart and in my life, and I would decrease. Please, Father, give me wisdom, humility, and love, that I would treasure, love, and serve you first, and others second. My natural, sinful state. I love me first, you second, and people last. And this is not the way you've commanded your children to live. Help for those around me. Bless those around me beyond measure, that their hearts would be totally devoted to you. Lead those around me in your ways, that the ways of the world would not entice. Give them heart. The world sees science and the universe as their God. We recognize you as Creator, worthy one, holy and good. I pray for this broken world, that they would be set free and saved. Jesus, good God, gentle Spirit, Holy Father, move through this wicked world, this world that has defied you generation after generation. Cleanse and make new. In your power, in your will, the light of Christ would find the darkened hearts and fill the great void that is so great. Be glorified, O great God, as we seek your will every day. Everything is vanity. Over the years, I have read Ecclesiastes and marveled at these chapters. Seasons as well as spiritual. There is a time for everything in this world, and we must accept that it is all vanity. The only things in life that are not in vain are God's purposes, and the life to come are for the Lord and in the Lord's plan, and nothing in heaven is vain. Solomon says that in places of authority and places of righteousness, even there lies wickedness. How true and unsurprising. The world is evil. And so are the inhabitants, we mustn't forget. Like a child distracted with something pleasing to the eye, mankind is persuaded by appearance and charm, all the while their heart is prone to destruction. I pray that the Lord wolves and sheep's clothing, and protect us from ever becoming those people ourselves, both we can be blind to. I pray we always walk in integrity and in humility, in Jesus' name. My God, Father Almighty, please work on me this day. Give me vision. Give me insight to see all that you do. I am blinded by my own selfishness many days and fail to practice loving you, loving others more than myself. Please put flames of resentment that ignite from time to time when thinking of certain people or experiences. And let flames of love and understanding take place instead. Let my heart be shaped and transformed by you, Holy Spirit. You who hovered over the void and created all that is seen, hover over my heart, fill it with life and light. Please be pleased with my heart, I pray. Amen. Father, thank you for your glorious hand in my life. You give me wisdom in my human stupidity, hope in my hopelessness, and answers in my confusion. The temporal vanities are swallowing me whole, and I have been consumed by them. Forgive me and cleanse me, O Holy God of all. Give me the same fire to do your work in serving church members, in serving the lost. I am wicked by nature, and like an infant, I open my needy arms to you asking for help. I pray you would give me Solomon's wisdom. I would understand the vanities under the sun and not be tricked into believing they are my jewels and my identity. I pray your hand would be over those who need healing. Oh Father, we are in need of you. Please help those who are mourning. Is you I look to. When life becomes bland, hopeless, haunting, it is only you who can waken the soul and revive it. Revive this broken world, I pray, in Jesus' name. Father, Almighty God of the universe, thank you for life. Thank you for this blessed existence filled with light and three-dimensional joy. Yes, some days are harder than others, but there can be far worse things in life that could happen. I try not to think of those things. Grateful to my Creator for all that I have. Bless my fellow man and my neighbor, O God of Israel. Bless those in great need and show me how to serve and deeply love those you set in my path. Let those who do not know you know the love of Jesus and be changed and transformed by you. I pray you would work in their hearts and set them free from all chains. me, Lord, to be self-disciplined. It is a challenge for me more than ever, but not impossible. I humble myself before you and know I am weak, and how much I need you in all things. I praise you and thank you in Jesus' name. In my thoughts I write. Struggles can help you if you let them. If you drag them from the depths where they are tossed and buried away, seemingly left burned without trace. If we look at them, at their ugly disfigured faces, imaging an inadequate version of ourselves, so pitiful we can barely gaze at this monstrosity. But they tell us much about ourselves. How? Because everything we dislike about ourselves and our lives provides us with a blueprint of everything we truly want for ourselves. It is a big revealer struggle, for good and bad. I've often had to think and remap my blueprint for a fulfilled life. Something has to give. See their value above my own. How hard it is to love others as yourself when you love yourself too much. Giving the self abundance of gifts, praise, time, and focus. How hard it is to love others this way when the cup for self is full. God, forgive me and plant my feet firmly. Help me to focus on the needs of others and have great empathy and compassion. As you see fit, Lord, as you see fit. I found the prayer I wrote on Sunday, April 25th, 2021. This is the prayer I wrote right before I started this journey. Lord, I am getting ready to start a Christian YouTube channel and humbly come before you asking for wisdom, guidance, and comfort as things me from evil. I can only imagine what darts the evil one will send my way. Please, keep us all under your wings and teach us as we go. You are an awesome God, mighty and powerful. You remind me how our days are numbered, and how quickly our days pass. You remind me how incredibly blessed we are to even have life, air in our lungs, bodies infused with souls. How very lucky we are. And I pray we wouldn't take it for granted. Open your prodigal sons and daughters' eyes so they see, ears so they can hear, praise and confess, hearts so they can pray, and lives so they can truly live. Be praised, O God, none is more deserving than you. In Jesus' name, Lord God Almighty, thanks be to you for your sovereignty. My soul is so troubled by this very sick and troubled moment, and I wonder how you can stand it. How can you be so incredibly patient and so merciful to such blatant wickedness? I am thankful you are both forgiving and righteous. I know I am in need of your patience and forgiveness every day. This world is tough, but we work hard, Lord, and ask that you would help us to be more loving and others focused. Help us to let go of every idle, overwhelming want and selfishness. Help us to serve our churches, our people. Pray for self-discipline with food and luxury. Please help us to be better, to run to you for all satisfaction. Father, be pleased with my whole life. You know what is in man, and therefore you know what is in me. Sanctify this soul daily, and pour forth godly wisdom unlike I have ever received before. My days are filled, and Lord, life is full and can feel like one giant to-do list. Help us to keep our eyes on you. Lord, I take comfort in knowing you. Knowing you know all thoughts that float around my head, and I can rest knowing your spirit is in control of everything. Worries can float away. Anger settles. But love can pure and amplify selflessness. I rest in your hands completely. Pray, Lord, for an unreal love, that I would love others as you love. In Jesus' name. Father, lover of my soul, you are who you say you are. Thank you for awakening my being and reviving your personhood to my mind. I am moved when I understand more. I pray the words that touch my heart would be shared with the world around me, and your purposes would be in motion. Many times I read of the raw and wild relationships the prophets would experience, the wonder, the awe, the supernatural lives. serve you in this season, Dad, I will. Who can I feed? Who can I bless? Lord, I want to pay it forward as you have done for me. Lord, I desire to change my affection towards money, luxury, status. I desire to live like I have nothing. Perhaps living like it's not our world would be best. I pray, Lord, you would protect me online with whatever evil comes my way. Please shield me from it. Protect me and those on this platform. I am unable to fight wolves, but I know you see and can destroy evil. If any of this is ever wrong, Father, take it away. I will serve you till my last day. Father, Almighty God, what is happening in this strange world? Why does the corruption continue rampantly? Is there an end to the madness of this twisted generation that is hungry, ravenous, relentless in turning God's word? What is good and upright is bad and oppressive. What's bad and oppressive is this age's version of good and upright. How long can it go for? The Lord heals the broken, but injures the pride of the upright. Religious hypocrites, their egos bruised, personas revealed as a sham, whitewashed tombs. On the insides. Snakes, poison, proud scam artists, greedy and self-indulgent, callous to the needy, sought to receive wealth, fame, and power, corrupt to the very core, ravenous wolves in sheepskin, hungry to prey on the weak, confused and living in self. We must be careful. We do not see ourselves outside of being this way. If they have deceived themselves, so we can deceive ourselves. We must bring our hearts before you, Lord, and choose to do things for you in secret. The world will puff up its chest and say, in pride, when being good, charitable or loving, but the humble will be exalted and the proud will be humbled. Father, you have brought me out of darkness and confusion when I was neck deep in it many years ago. Lord, you have given me sound theology, beautiful church family, and introduced me to a life that is fulfilled. This is the first time, Lord, where I see amazing things happening in my work. I ask you, Lord, that I do not worship or idolize any of it. I pray that you would not be disappointed in my heart. I owe my entire life to you, O King. You've done much for me, Lord. I thank you and pray I would do what pleases you. In Jesus' name. Lord Almighty, you are Creator. You reign on high, just yet merciful, powerful yet restraining, patient yet swift to act. These are not contradictions of character, but reminders of your many attributes. Lord, is it strange hearing mere humans repeat your characteristics that you've said of yourself? Or does it connect us better to you? Creation acknowledges its creator. What an honor it is to be human, made in your likeness, for your will and for your purposes. To warm my heart with the reminders of who for giving us hope, for giving us soundness and wholeness. There is hope in you, oh God. Flood our hearts. Change this broken, disjointed system on perpetual self-destruct. Fill our lives, Lord. Lead us to you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hello, friends. Today's video is a little bit different. I will be reading my prayer journal to you. Prayers about gratitude, the world, my battles, all spiritual things in Christ. I hope you will be blessed. And as I read to you, I'm just going to use this pen brush as your relaxation trigger. Lord Almighty, I lift my eyes up to you and worship the great God that you are. Perfect are your ways, holy, upright, and wonderful. You tell us to walk humbly and to seek you, obey you, and trust in you. And that is what I do, Father, on this very morning. Seek you in order that you would increase in my heart and in my life, and I would decrease. Please, Father, give me wisdom, humility, and love, that I would treasure, love, and serve you first, and others second. My natural, sinful state, I love me first, you second, and people last. And this is not the way you've commanded your children to live. Help me, Lord, to adopt a better character, rooted the world sees science and the universe as their God. We recognize you as Creator, worthy one, holy and good. I pray for this broken world, that they would be set free and saved by the Jesus, good God, gentle Spirit, Holy Father, move through this wicked world, this world that has defied you generation after generation. Cleanse and make new. In your power, in your will, in whatever way you see fit. Bless the people at church, Lord. Bless them in all ways. We thank you, Lord, for glorified, O great God, as we seek your will every day. Everything is vanity. Over the years, I have read Ecclesiastes and marveled at these chapters, and how ages later, they still remain true. The world has physical seasons as well as spiritual. There is a time for everything in this world, and we must accept that it is all vanity. The only things in life that are not in vain are God's purposes, and the life to come that is everlasting. These are for the Lord and in the Lord's plans, and nothing in heaven is vain. Solomon says that in places of authority and places of righteousness, even there lies wickedness. How true and unsurprising. The world is evil, and so are the inhabitants, we mustn't forget. Like a child distracted with something pleasing to the eye, mankind is persuaded by appearance and charm, all the while their heart is prone to destruction. I pray that the Lord God would keep us from wolves in sheep's clothing, and protect us from ever becoming those people ourselves. Both we can be blind to. I pray we always walk in integrity and in humility, in Jesus' name. My God, Father Almighty, please work on me this day. Give me vision. Give me insight to see all that you do. I am blinded by my own selfishness many days, and fail to practice loving you, loving others more than myself. Please put flames of resentment that ignite from time to time when thinking of certain people or experiences, and let flames of love and understanding and my heart be shamed and transformed by you, Holy Spirit. You who hovered over the void and created all that is seen, hover over my heart, fill it with life and light. Please be pleased with my heart, I pray. Amen. Father, thank you for your glorious hand in my life. You give me wisdom in my human stupidity, hope in my hopelessness, and answers in my confusion. The temporal vanities are swallowing me whole, and I have been consumed by them. Forgive me and cleanse me, O Holy God of all. Give me the same fire to do your work in serving church members and serving the lost. I am wicked by nature, and like an infant, I open my needy arms to you, asking for help. I pray you would give me Solomon's wisdom. I would understand the vanities under the sun and not be tricked into believing they are my joys and my identity. I pray your hand would be over those who need healing. Oh, Father, we are in need of you. Please help those who are mourning. Is you I look to. When life becomes bland, hopeless, haunting, it is only you who can waken the soul and revive it. Revive this broken world, I pray, in Jesus' name. Father, Almighty God of the universe, thank you for life. Thank you for this blessed existence filled with light and three-dimensional joy. Yes, some days are harder than others, but there can be far worse things in life that could happen. I try not to think of those things. Grateful to my Creator for all that I have. Bless my fellow man and my neighbor, O God of Israel. Bless those in great need and show me how to serve and deeply love those you set in my path. Let those who do not know you know the love of Jesus and be changed and transformed by you. I pray you would work in their hearts and set them free from all chains. Help me, Lord, to be self-disciplined. It is a challenge. I humble myself before you and know I am weak and how much I need you in all things. I praise you and thank you in Jesus' name. In my thoughts I write, struggles can help you if you let them, if you drag them from the depths where they are tossed and buried away, seemingly left burned without a trace. If we look at them, at their ugly disfigured faces, imaging an inadequate version of ourselves, so pitiful we can barely gaze at this monstrosity. But they tell us much about ourselves. Because everything we dislike about ourselves and our lives provides us with a blueprint of everything we truly want for ourselves and our lives. It is a big revealer struggle for good and bad. I've often had to think and remap my blueprint for a fulfilled life. Something has to give. There are only so many hours. There are only so many days. Something will always seem to take the back burner. But facing our fear, facing the truth is sometimes harder than facing the struggle. Both are painful in their own ways. Father in heaven, good, righteous, and upright you are. is your character. All is vanity under the sun. And oh, how it is all-consuming. Finding moments to truly worship and be in your completed joy and rest is a struggle, a fault of my own. Ground me and teach me your ways. Let me find great stillness, even while my life progresses. Lord, it is hard to remain humble in many ways. To live humbly, choose humbly. Remain this way even when lifted up by others. Humility is a daily choice, and it is only truly achieved when it is in line with you. Help me to see others, to see their value above my own. How hard it is to love others as yourself when you love yourself too much. Giving the self abundance of gifts, praise, time, and focus. How hard it is to love others this way when the cup for self is full. God, forgive me and plant my feet firmly. Help me to focus on the needs of others and have great empathy and compassion. As you see fit, Lord. Found the prayer I wrote on Sunday, April 25th, 2021. This is the prayer I wrote right before I started this channel. Lord, I am getting ready to start a Christian YouTube channel and humbly come before you asking for wisdom, guidance, and comfort as things happen. Lead me away from temptation and lead me to discipline and obedience. Deliver me from evil. I can only imagine what darts the evil one will send my way. Please keep us all under your wings and teach us as we go. You are an awesome God, mighty and powerful. You remind me how our days are numbered and how quickly our days pass. You remind me how incredibly blessed we are to even have life. Air in our lungs, bodies infused with souls. How very lucky we are. And I pray we wouldn't take it for granted. Open your prodigal sons and daughters' eyes so they see, ears so they can hear, lips so they can praise and confess, hearts so they can pray, and lives so they can truly live. Be praised, O God. None is more deserving than you. In Jesus' name, Lord God Almighty, thanks be to you for your sovereignty. My soul is so troubled by this very sick and troubled world, and I wonder how you can stand it. How can you be so incredibly patient and so merciful to such blatant wickedness? I am thankful you are both forgiving and righteous. I know I am in need of your patience and forgiveness every day. This world is tough, but we work hard, Lord, and ask that you would help us to be more loving and others focused. Help us to let go of every idle, overwhelming want and selfishness. Help us to serve our churches, pray for self-discipline with food and luxury. Please help us to be better, to run to you for all satisfaction. Father, be pleased with my whole life. You know what is in man, and therefore you know what is in me. Sanctify this soul daily, and pour forth godly wisdom and insight unlike I have ever received before. My days are filled, and Lord, life is full and can feel like one giant to-do list. Help us to keep our eyes on you. Lord, I take comfort in knowing you. Knowing you know all thoughts that float around my head. And I can rest knowing your spirit is in control of everything. Worries can float away. Anger settles. But love and pure and amplify a selflessness. I rest in your hands completely, Lord. I pray, Lord, for an unreal love, that I would love others as you love, in Jesus' name. Father, lover of my soul, you are who you say you are. Thank you for awakening my being and reviving your personhood to my mind. I am moved when I understand more of who you are. I pray the words that touched my heart would be shared with the world around me, and your purposes would be in motion. Many times I read of the raw and wild relationships the prophets would experience, the wonder, the awe, the supernatural lives. Oh, I am hungry for it. Is there a way to live this way and still be a responsible person in society? Perhaps it is selfish, I don't know. Learn from you, Father. Open my heart and eyes in Jesus' name. Amen. Father Yahweh, search me. My life is in your hands. Tell me how to serve you in this season, and I will. Who can I feed? Who can I bless? Lord, I want to pay it forward as you have done for me. Lord, I desire to change my affection towards money, luxury, status. I desire to live like I have nothing. Perhaps living like it's not our world would be best. I pray, Lord, you would protect me online with whatever evil comes my way. Please shield me. Protect me and those on this platform. I am unable to fight wolves, but I know you see and can destroy evil at its door. If any of this is ever wrong, Father, take it away. I will serve you till my last day. Father, Almighty God, what is happening in this strange world? Why does the corruption continue rampantly? Is there an end to the madness of this twisted generation that is hungry, ravenous, relentless in turning God's word upside down? What is good and upright is bad and oppressive. What's bad and oppressive is this age's version of good and upright. The Lord heals the broken, but injures the pride of the upright, religious hypocrites. their egos bruised, personas revealed as a sham, whitewashed tombs rotten on the insides, snakes, poison, proud scam artists, greedy and self-indulgent, callous to the needy, sought to receive wealth, fame, and power, corrupt to the very core, ravenous wolves in sheepskin, hungry to prey on the weak, confused and living in self-deceit. We must be careful. We do not see ourselves outside of being this way. If they have deceived themselves, so we can deceive ourselves. We must bring our hearts before you, Lord, and choose to do things for you in secret. The world will puff up its chest and say, in pride, when being good, charitable, or loving. But the humble will be exalted, and the proud will be humbled. Father, you have brought me out of darkness and confusion. When I was neck deep in it many years ago, Lord, you have given me sound theology, beautiful church family, and introduced me to a life that is fulfilled. This is the first time, Lord, where I see amazing things happening in my work. I ask you, Lord, that I do not worship or idolize any of pray that you would not be disappointed in my heart. I owe my entire life to you, O King. You've done much for me, Lord. I thank you and pray I would do what pleases you. In Jesus' name. Lord Almighty, you are Creator, you reign on high. Just, yet merciful. Powerful, yet restraining. Patient, yet swift to act. These are not contradictions of character, but reminders of your many attributes. Lord, is it strange hearing mere humans repeat your characteristics that you've said of yourself? Or does it connect us better to you? Creation acknowledges its creation. What an honor it is to be human, made in your likeness, for your will and for your purposes. To warm my heart with reminders of who you are. We are worms apart from you. Yet you are high above all the filth of humanity. You adopt and care for us as your own. All life avenues are useless and destructive if they do not lead to you. All is vanity. And Lord, I thank you for giving us hope, for giving us soundness and wholeness. There is hope in you, O God. Flood our hearts. Change this broken, disjointed system on perpetual self